Okay, welcome back. Last time, if any of you saw it, we had the last little prototype electrolyzer built with wire in the jar. And unfortunately, I thought I was using stainless steel surgical wire, but if you read the box carefully, it just says surgical corrosion resisting steel. It does not say stainless steel. And so it helps if you read. Anyhow. So we're going to toss that aside. We're going to get rid of this bundle of wire because the electrolyzer ate right through it. Now remember, on this prototyping, I know a lot of you probably have seen this kind of stuff before. We are not using positive electricity. We're using negative electricity. So we're dealing with negentropy instead of entropy. Entropy is where things heat up, break down, expand. Negentropy is just the opposite. It's very renewing. It's very healing. If you're not familiar with that, you have to go read up on the Bedini machine, the SSGs. That's what we got here. This produces a radiant energy spike. It's what Tesla worked with. It produces that negative energy. And so I'm not going to go into that right now. You'll have to go read up on that on your own. John Bedini is the inventor of that. He pursued Tesla's experiments and was successful. So anyhow, we're going to go kind of fast here because I want to assume you know what you're doing. Otherwise, you wouldn't be looking into this and or attempting this. If you do not know how to do some of these mechanical handy things, try and find someone who can. So I'm going to go kind of fast and hopefully you'll be able to follow. So what we need is we need a support mechanism for the stainless steel wire. Now, this is stainless steel this time. I checked into it. It's 304 or 316. It doesn't matter, but 316 would be nice. 316L, to be specific. This is 302, 304 stainless. It says so right there. You can pick this up at Harbor Freight. It's one of my little candy stores. Wonderful store. I think it was either at Boeing Surplus or somewhere. Some sort of surplus store online. Anyhow, so what we're going to do is we're going to create this. This is what we had before. And there's little ridges that run down here. And this is what holds the wires, keeps them separate. Keeps the negative away from the positive all the way down. And that will slide into one of these jars here like this. It'll be attached to the lid like that. It'll be screwed in. And so it'll come out as one piece like that. And the two leads of the stainless wire will come out the lid. So I'm just going to show you how to do that real quick. What I did is I grabbed a jar, any old type of mason or ball Kerr type jar. This one's this one's kind of fruity, so we're going to skip on that one. You know, like I say, don't ask, don't tell. So we're going to stick with regular lids. Anyhow, so you take a lid like this, and you're going to need to mark it with an X. So take the width of your acrylic that you have here, and you're just going to make a cross like that, and then 90 degrees you're going to make a cross like that, okay? And then that's where we're going to drill a hole on each end of that cross, and that's going to correlate with the hole in here. So after we get the holes punched in, they'll be able to mark the acrylic rod and get that lined up and drill the holes, and they'll be self-threading screws that go in there. So what I did is, if you got somebody to cut you some acrylic rod, this is about 1 inch by that's probably about a quarter inch, and you're going to need it the length of the jar. Okay, so cut a little bit short so it hangs from the bottom. Mark it. And then what I do is I put these in a vise, and you're going to take a hacksaw, and you're going to do all four at once, and you're going to go down about 1/16 of an inch, just to make enough of a notch, and then move over 1/16 of an inch and make another row, another row, another row, all the way down those length of those rods. And then, of course, just peel the paper off the back of these, and it's just acrylic clear, acrylic. And go from there. Then you're going to take the four of these, and you're going to take some acrylic cement, and you're going to glue these together like this, and like this, and you're going to make a plus sign out of it, like that. Okay? So once you get that accomplished, and you get to this point, go ahead and take your lid that you've marked, drill the four holes, 1, 2, 3, 4. You're going to drill the big hole because you want to put a rubber grommet in here with some surgical tubing for your gas out emissions. And then you're going to drill two holes on the either side of one of the acrylic markings, one of the plus markings here, so you can put your leads so they go through and they won't touch. They'll be separated by the acrylic rod. So as you can see under here, those holes are on either side of that plus. So I don't know if you can see that, but if you can't, trust me, it's there. So once you got that done, we're going to go ahead and pop these screws in here. And if I can remember which way this was lined up, should be like that. So go ahead and screw this lid on. Then we're going to stuff this rubber grommet in here. It's got a groove down the middle, so it's going to fit right inside that hole. And then we're going to put the rubber surgical tubing inside that grommet, and that'll make a nice airtight fit. Okay, so the grommet's in. And sometimes it's hard to get this because this is kind of sticky, so it's hard to stuff it in here. So you can grab some lighter fluid or some isopropyl alcohol, 99% or 70%, whatever you pick up, because these work as a beautiful lubricant to help slip things in. It becomes real slippery, and you can just kind of pop things in a little bit easier without too much effort. And then, of course, it just evaporates and doesn't leave any residue with the isopropyl, whereas with the lighter fluid, you get a little bit of residue, and then it makes your hands stink, so whatever you care to use or have on hand. So I just push it through. A quarter inch is good enough because you don't want it coming up into the fluid, into the water. And if we have to, we'll put a little screen here to keep the bubbles if we get too out of control with our electrolyzer process. Okay, so that's done. Got this screwed on. You got the holes for the lead on either side of the acrylic here. And then we're going to string our wire and hold our wire in place before we string it up. We need to drill some holes in the acrylic because there are going to be two separate wires that are not going to touch all the way down. These are not going to touch. This is pretty thick wire. A lot thicker than what I had before, so this might be a little more difficult. Hopefully I've got enough too. If I don't, I'll use the other stainless and we'll just make it happen. So you're going to need to grab a drill bit about as thick or thicker than that. It's not going to fit in my big drill, so we're going to have to use a little Dremel here. And we'll just punch a hole down here in the bottom. Like that. Through. And we're just going to bend it over. At a 90. Like that. That way it stops. And then we're just going to start wrapping. And after we get to the after we get around here, you have to skip this one where the hole is and move up a notch, because you gotta make room for that other wire. So now I'm going every other notch, so you can see it starting to angle. If you don't do that, you're gonna have to redo the whole thing, and it's a real pain in the butt. So we're just gonna wrap it around here, and I'm putting a little tension on it. I'm pulling it tight, but as you can see, it's just falling right in the groove nicely. And I'm using the curl of the stainless. It's already on a coil, so I'm kind of using that to my advantage to wrap around this thing so it's staying curled, so I'm not having to do a lot of rebending of the wire. And this isn't the most efficient electrolyzer process, whether you're using positive or negative electricity. I can tell you that right now, because your surface area is very minimal throughout this whole process. You don't have a big surface area of metal to metal to create that electrolysis process. So you want plates. You want stainless steel plates facing each other. But for a quick and dirty electrolyzer, to do prototyping of different materials, different processes, different solutions, different electrolyte, positive or negative type electricities, different pulse width modulation, great, great tool to have to just hook it up and go. It's all self-contained, it's in a jar, it's quick to pull out these electrolyzer, this whole unit. You know, it's attached to the lid, so it pops out real quick, and just good for, you know, small home bench testing. That's why I'm building this, because you get quick results. It's easy to change solution fast. Easy to film. Nice clear glass jar. Okay, and you're going to want to keep these straight, because when you get that second set of wire in here, you're only going to have a 16th of an inch or less between these wires. So if they're bent, they're going to touch. And so you want to make sure you don't bend them up too much as you go around here. And then we can go back and straighten them, because it'll be easy to see if they're touching. And then we can do a continuity test between the probes and make sure there's no contact. And that'll be our final test with a little multimeter. Okay, so as we get up here to the top, we're going to need to cut the stainless and run it through the hole, and then we're going to slip some heat shrink tubing over the wire so it doesn't touch the metal plate lid here, and really gotta watch here. Go on every other one, because it's easy to miss one, and if you do, you gotta unwind this and go all the way back and start over from that point. So pay attention to what you're doing. I know I'm focusing so much on getting this thing right that I don't miss a beat, that sometimes I hold it too high and I get it out of the camera lens, so I apologize for that. Okay, we're down to the last one here. So We ended right here at this point. So we're going to cut enough so I can feed it up through that hole and let that lead stick out. So we'll cut it right there. That should be enough. And get this right so that it ends on the right side, on the correct side. So I come to the first hole. That's that one right there. Okay, so if you do it to the second hole, then you won't have any room to fit the one to the last hole. So we're going to feed it through here. Pull it out because it's pretty stiff. I guess you definitely know it's stainless when you can hardly bend the stuff. Okay. Now we got it. So we got to get that one up there in that notch. Got this one to this notch. And straighten this out right here. It lines up nice. I'm going to pull her tight and bend her over so it'll quit backing out on me here. There we go. Okay, so that side's done. And so you know what to do with the other side. I just wanted you to see this so you got the idea. And then I'm going to get the other lead in there. You're just going to take this lid, feed the leads and the hose through there so you got your screw lid on there. And then this is just going to slide inside the jar. You're going to tighten the lid down like that. And you have your little mini electrolyzer. It's stable. It's not going to shake around. It's very, very good prototyping instrument. And then what we're going to do is we're going to hook up these leads to our Bedini Energizer like this, and start her up, and we're going to get that nice pulse going into the jar, and we're going to get the disassociation of the oxygen-hydrogen because it's going to unhappen, as Tom Bearden calls it, and it's going to reverse the process, the negentropy. You're going to reverse the process of the bonds, so you're not going to force them apart with brute force like you're trying to do with all the voltage and amperage with positive electricity. This is just a radiant pulse to unhappen the hydrogen-oxygen bond, so it takes very little energy, no heat involved, no amperage, very little if any, and it's a much simpler process. Makes a lot more sense. And I do believe that's what Stanley Meyer was doing with all his chokes and all his schematics that he produced. If you look at them, they're very similar setups as John Bedini's setups. So a lot of people have been kind of barking up the wrong tree with all this positive electricity stuff. Trying to develop these circuits and force the hydrogen-oxygen bonds apart. And that's been a real issue. So there you go. When I come back, we'll have this done. You can see it. We'll have the water electrolyte in there, and we'll hook it up to the SSG and pulse it and see what kind of results you get. Thanks a lot.